This is from Laurie in San Francisco, who says, dear Craig, this new guy I'm seeing is really nice, but a terrible kisser. Should I dump him or try and teach an old dog a new trick? I don't know how you could. How did you bring it up to say someone that they're a terrible kisser? You just have to say, I don't kiss like that, I'm Swedish or something. We kiss in a different way, like this. About 2 feet apart. Oh, no, no, if somebody... That would be bad if someone you were going to... Well, you know, marry them and then you'll stop kissing, you'll be fine.
Scandinavian. I know
you seem to be very attached to the Scandinavians. Yeah. When you did Hamlet, you did it all up in... Well, Danish, Denmark is... Yes, it is set in Denmark,
yes,
to be fair.
Yes, it is, so that's good.
And then didn't you play a Scandinavian detective?
I was a Swedish detective. I noticed with interest, Craig, earlier on, that you gave an impression of Swedish kissing. Which seemed to me, yes. Now, on what experience is that based? Because it does not tally with my own experience of the Swedes in that mode.
Well, how many Swedes did you kiss?
Well, I didn't kiss them. I was watching them occasionally.
Right, know, right. Well, they disguise it when foreigners are in. But I was accepted as one of them by... I defeated their leader. I look forward to your letters.
it feels like I can't really do it, but it feels like an exposed way of doing it, which in the northern climes in the winter you do that tongue could stick somewhere. Yeah, very unfortunate.
That's true. The days have passed with me putting my tongue in unfortunate places. Well. Well, especially cold in the cold. Did you make your Swedish detective show in Sweden?
Yes, yeah, and we're going to do some more of them. We go to Sweden and do the part of southern Sweden called Skåne, and it's also very close to the border with Denmark, so you can go quickly to Copenhagen as well.
You're living the dream, man.
I'm living the dream.
I mean, Sweden, Denmark, Sweden.
I mean, you can literally, in the course of one day, you can be in two cities, and if you go home at the end of the day to England, you've done three. That's Europe for you.
Europe. You can do it all in a train.
Exactly.
Yeah. Over the ocean.
Yeah, yeah. I mean that bit's harder, in all honesty. Yeah. That
Have you ever been to... You're in Stockholm a lot now.
Well, actually, we're near Malmo, and down that end of things. But I know Stockholm well.
Have you been to Cafe Opera in Stockholm?
I have not. Tell me about it. Is it... Well, what happens there? Oh, really? Now, tell me, does the position of the tongue change? Is it always like that? Or, for instance, because it always looks as though you're kissing someone who's just behind you.
Yeah, there you are. Now you're catching on,
And then I've taken myself to a place I didn't really want to go.
Australia, 20 years ago, exactly.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah. So, yeah.